Good morning, students. In this session is the continuation of Geography First Unit Resources. Before entering this lesson, we just recall few things from the last class. What is resources? Anything can fulfill the human needs can be called our resources. Okay? The resources can be classified into two based on the value. Already we have discussed. Each and everything has a value. But the same thing, resources also have a value. So based on the value, resources can be classified into two: commercial resources and non-commercial resources. Then again, resources can be classified into three: natural resources, man-made resources, human resources. So from this, natural resources, again, it can be classified into different groups based on the origin, based on the development, based on the accessibility, based on the distribution, based on the ownership. So these are the things we have discussed in the last class. So if we take based on the origin means, again, it's classified into two: biotic and abiotic. Then development, based on the development, again it's classified into two: actual and potential. If we take accessibility, we can call as renewability. So based on that, again it's classified into two: renewable, non-renewable. Distribution, same thing, it can be classified into localized and universal. Now again, if we take ownership, again it's classified into four: that individual, then community owned, national, international. So after ownership, the natural resources we have completed in the previous class. Now in this session we are going to discuss about man-made resources and human resources. What is man-made resources? Proceeded by the man. If we take natural resources, sun, air, water, animals, plants, all the living things, we can call as a natural resources. So when natural resources are modified or proceed by the man using with a technology, that's called man-made resources. So if we say simply, natural resources are modified or processed by the technology into man-made resources. For example, if we take sugar cane, is this natural resources or not? Yeah, we know it's a plant, so we can take as a natural resources. So when the sugar cane processed or when it's modified by the technology, by the man, to get sugar, this is called man-made resources. So when we use the natural resources to get another thing, we get another resources by the technology, that's called man-made resources. Not only the planets, we can take as all the structures, for example, houses, apartments, bridges, then roads. These are the things also called as a man-made resources. Because of that human use the natural resources to get new things. That's called man-made resources. For example, so we are watching all the things outside. So when we are traveling the road, national highway, we can see the road. So which are the important natural resources can be used for the roads? What are the natural resources are necessary to lay a road? What are the things? If we say simply means sand or the crushed rocks, we can say. But the important thing is asphalt and the concrete. So these are the things are very important to lay the roads. So if we take asphalt means it uses to an oil-based, we can see that a black color, that oil-based things, that's called bitumen. So bitumen to make sand and crust rocks to, what is that, to join together, stick together like a glue. So these are the things we have used to lay our roads, asphalts and concrete. If you see village site, inside the streets they are using the concrete roads only. So natural resources means the asphalts and the concrete they used to lay our roads. Then, so we know in a previous class we have discussed about primary activities. What is primary activities? In an ancient world, they were leading a nomadic life, we know very well. So they are moving one place to another place to search the food. So for their food, they use that farming, fishing, forestry, so hunting. So these are the things they did for their food. So when they use the natural activities, they use the natural activities, use the environmental, that's called primary activities. So primary activities means they use the raw material by their activities of hunting, fishing, forestry. These are the activities they did. That's called primary. So what is secondary activity? So when the human use the natural resources or raw materials into get a new resources. For example, I said sugar cane. It's a natural resources. So they modified into get the sugar. So that the same thing only. Secondary activities means this transforming of raw materials into finished goods is called secondary activity. So secondary activity means this transforming. They use the technology, they use the raw materials into finished goods is called a secondary activity. So primary activity means they use the raw materials. Secondary activity means the manufacturing activities. So men, skills and ideas, how they use the natural resources to get the another resources by the human skill and the ideas. So these are the things are very important to get the new resources. By that only they are manufacturing so many resources by the natural resources. Then next one, human resources. Usually human means that's also can called as a natural resources. But what did they do? They classified the human resources into separately. Why did they classify the human resources separately? Because of that, if you compare with the other natural resources, humans only have a sixth sense. So by their knowledge, education, health and the skill, by their education, by their skill, by their knowledge, they can make a new different types of resources. That's why they classify the human resources into a separate resources. If we say simply means human resources also natural resources only, but from their skill, knowledge, education, they separately call as a human resources also one of the resource. Okay, by their, if it's, I said, they have a knowledge, education, skills, health, everything. Then for the example, if we say means doctors, teachers, scientists, because what they are doing in their daily life, they use their knowledge, they use their skills, that's why they make a new different types of resources. That's why human is one of the resources. Then primary, I said, it's a raw material. Secondary means that's a manufacturing. What is tertiary activity? So in the beginning, they use the raw material. From the raw material, they use the they make different types of resources. So tertiary activities means from the primary and the secondary products through a system of transport. They pass the things one place to another place, or pass their sources one place to another place, one human to another human. That's called the tertiary activity. For example, banking, trading, or communication. So these are the activities called tertiary activities. So one more time, what is tertiary activities? That's all basically concerned with the distribution of primary and secondary. It's a distribution. Okay, services. If you say simply, services. So the primary and secondary products through a system of transport or trade. That's only called a tertiary activities. Okay, we know human has a skill. Each and every human has a different skills, knowledge, then wealth, skills, everything. So how we can say that this place and this society has a more number of human resources? Which place has a more than number of resources? How we can say that? The quantity and the quality of institution based on the quality, how the institutions, what are the famous institutions are located in this place, based on the quality of resources, institutions, and the quantity, how many number of institutions are available in this place. So based on the quality and quantity of institutions and the organization. So based on that only we can say that the professional decide the human resources of a country. How many human resources that country has, we can classify into the quality and quantity of the institutions and the organization. So in your book, in a page number 149, some of the example pictures are given to you. So when you go through that, you just check, it's an activity only. Okay, identify the personality and the professional. How we can classify that? This is a famous personality. This is a famous profession. So we can easily say that. Okay, first picture is given, Valluvar, Thiruvalluvar. We know very well, it's a professional or personality. Thiruvalluvar is a personality, famous figure. Because he was a famous Tamil poet and also philosopher. Then second picture, it's a Albert Einstein. He also one of the famous scientists, German scientist. Then third picture is given, Marie Curie. We know very well, she's also, she was one of the famous chemist and the physics, French physics and chemistry. Then fourth picture is given, a traffic constable. Is this the professional or personality? We can say it's a profession only, not a personality. If become a very popular person, they made some interesting things to the people, means we can call it as a personality. So the fourth picture is a traffic constable. Then fifth one is a Nelson Mandela. We know very well, he was born in South Africa. Then he was an anti-apartheid revolutionary leader. He was one of the famous leader in South Africa. Then last picture is a bus driver. He is also one of the professional. It's a small activity, you just mark in your book, okay? Then next, we are going to discuss about the interesting topic, Gandhian thought of resources. What he said about the resources. Not only Gandhi, so many people, so many leaders, they said about the resources, but the particular thing, Gandhian thought on resources, what he said about the resources. There is enough for everybody's needs. If we take our world, we can see so many resources are available in the world. It's enough for us, but and not for anybody's greed. So we can use all the resources for our need, but it does not for anybody's greed. So what Gandhi said about the resources, there is enough for everybody's need and not for anybody's greed. Okay, so from that, Gandhiji blamed human beings. He blamed them. Why he blamed the resources? Are we using the resources properly? We have saved the resources for our future generation? No. We are, what is that? Waste the resources. all the resources, human resources, man-made resources, and natural resources. We are wasting that day by day our life. We are wasting that. That's why Gandhi said, he blamed the human beings for explosion of resources. Explosions means we are producing the resources. That's why he blamed the human beings. Why he blamed that? First one, over explosion of resources. We are totally, more and more we are wasting the resources. That's why he blamed that. Second one, unlimited needs of human beings. What is that? Only the particular resources are available means unlimited things only it's there. So if we finished all the resources, unlimited resources are available in the world. In case if we finish that unlimited resources also, in the future we can't get anything. That's why he said unlimited needs of human beings. That's why he blamed the human beings for the two reasons. First reason is over exploitation of resources. Second one, unlimited needs of human beings. So that, what is it? Conservation is very important. Conservation, not only for the resources. If we take any activity or if we take anything, conservation is very important. Because now we are leading a, what is that, luxury life. So we are getting all the things from the nature. Now, then they are getting from the man-made resources also. But continuously, if we are using all the resources means, our future generation, they can't get anything from us. So conservation is very important activity, very important thing. How we can plan that? Conservation are very important, we know very well. How we can plan? How we are manage the resources? So first thing, resources planning. It's a very important. First, we have to plan which are the resources are available. Then which are the resources are limited. So first we plan all the things. So resources planning is a technique or skill or proper utilization of resources. So we have to understand. It's a keyword, it's a clue, technique, a skill. Then resources planning is necessary. Already I said, whatever we are doing, whatever we are starting, any business or any studies, before entering these topics or before entering their activities, first we very plan to enter into the activities. So planning is very important. That's why it's given resources planning is necessary. Because why we are saying that it's important, it's necessary. Resources are limited, their planning is quite necessary so that we can use them properly. So resources are limited, already I said. In our ancestor, they used all the natural resources. So for their food, they are moving one place to another place. So when they hunted all the animals in the particular place, they are moving to another place. So when they used all the plants, all the farming works, then they are moving one place to another place. So that the same thing only it's happened in our current situation also. So whatever we need, we are using all the things, water, air, sunlight, then we are polluting the, what is it? Pollution also, it's where, what is it? Destroyed the resources. So now it's very limited resources are available. Then that their planning is quite necessary. If you are not plan anything, we can't save the resources. So that we can use them properly. We know very well these are the resources are very limited in the current situation. So without planning, if you are using all the resources, in the future we can't get anything. That's why they are saying, what is it? We use them properly. We have to use the resources properly. And at the same time, we can save them for the future generation also. In case if you are not use any resources in a current situation, we saved all the resources for the future generation. That's not possible. We can't live in a current situation. So we have to plan how to save the resources. We use the resources for our needs. At the same time, we save the resources for the future generation also. Then second thing, resources are not only limited, but also they are unevenly distributed over the different parts of the world. If we take any one place in the world, if we take any one country, few resources are available in particular place. Then again, if we take another place in the world, then there some of the resources are available. So it's not even in the world. So it's uneven. Resources are not only limited, but also they are unevenly distributed over the different parts of the world. So in a north side, if they are using all the resources, they destroy that, they finish all the resources, means in a south side they can't get. So it's unevenly distributed all over the different parts of the world. So we have to plan. That's very important thing. Then third one, it's essential for the protection of resources to protect them from over exploitations. It's very important. It's essential for the protection. So instead of the natural resources, we have to plan alternative resources. We have to, what is that? Find that productions of resources to protect them from over explosions. So if we find out the another alternative resources, means we can save from the over the explosion. Then next one, planning, it's over. The next one, conservation of resources. Conservation. How we can save, protect, that control the resources. First thing, we plan the resources. We plan that, we identify our mistakes, then we identify what are the resources available, everything we plan that. The second important thing, the conservation of resources. How we can protect, how we can save the resources. First thing, the careful use of resources is called conservation of resources. First, we can understand how we can carefully use the resources. That's only called the conservation of resources. The careful use of resources is called conservation of resources. Then the resources are being used at very fast rate. We are using the resources very fast due to the population. When that population are increasing, when it increasing, all are using the resources. Because of the population, the resources are being used at very fast. So we understand the situation. So natural resources are depleting fast. Wisely using resources can control the depleting ratios. So we just understand what is the reasons to consume the resources. First, we understand that. First thing, that population. Population is a very main factor to use the resources. Then, if we are using the resources wisely, mean we can easily save the resources, nature, not only the natural resources, all the natural resources we can save that. Then the development is necessary without affecting the needs of the future generation. So resources are very limited, we know very well. It's not even in the world, we know very well. So population also affected the resources. Okay, so first, the development is very important. It's very necessary without affecting the needs of the future generation. Okay, we are developing, we are using the resources, we are making a man-made resources, all the resources are renewable resources we are using that pranayamas. So what they are saying that our development is necessary without affecting the needs of the future generation. Whatever we are producing, whatever we are using, whatever we are develop the resources, it does not affect the human needs. Okay, the next one, if the present needs of resources are met and the conserving of resources for the future are balanced. So what they are saying, in a current situation, we are all using the resources, but at the same time, we have to save the sources for their future generation also. We have to balance. That's called sustainable development. That's called sustainable development. What is sustainable development? One more time. The present needs of resources are met and the conservation of resources for the future are balanced. In the present and the future, both are balanced. Means that's only called sustainable development. So sustainable development can take place where we can use the sustainable developments. Then which are the places we can use? First thing, the reasons of depletion are identified. Okay, so where the resources are reducing, first we identify the situation, we identify the places. First thing is the reason of depletion or identify. We identify the reasons first. Second, wastage and excess consumption is prevented. We understand the wastage, whatever we are wasting, first we understand. And the excess of consumption, that using up, how we are using, how we are wasting the resources. Okay, we understand the usage and the wastage is prevented, to prevent that. Then third one, reusable resources are recycled. In case some of the resources we can use again, means we use the reuses, usable resources are recycled. We can recycle the resources. The next one, pollution is prevented. We save the nature, we save the environmental to use the resources. So pollution is prevented. The next one is environment is protected. We protect the environment. That's very important. Pollution also, we can control the pollution. We can control that. So we have to control, we have to take steps to control the pollution. Okay, next one, natural vegetation and wildlife are preserved. If we take any forest or any natural vegetations or wildlife are preserved, we have to protect all the wildlife, all the natural vegetation. If product means we can get more and more resources from the nature. So that's also very important. Next one, alternative resources are used. If you are using the particular resources again and again means, then in particular time it will be, what is it, destroyed. So instead of that, we are using the alternative resources. So that's also very important. So whatever we have discussed now, we just say that sustainable development can take place where? Which are the places they can take a sustainable development? First one, the reasons of depletion are identified. Identify the reasons. Then wastage and the usage is prevented. Next one, reusable resources are recycled. Population is prevented. Environment is protected. The natural vegetation and wildlife are preserved. Alternative resources are used. If we say simply how we can save the natural resources, they are giving 3 R's. They are giving 3 R's. What is 3 R's? First one, reduce. First one, reduce the thing. Then next one, reuse. We can use the things again, reuse. Then third one, recycle. So if we follow the three R's, we can easily save the resources. We can easily, conserve the resources. Three R's are very important. The first one, reduce. Second one, reuse. Third one, recycle. So understand, three R's mean reduce, reuse and recycle. So in our life, we also follow the three R's in our daily life, then we save the natural resources, all the resources. Then one more thing, in your book, page number 153, map work is given. I have given a sample map work. So after finishing this class, each and everyone get the outline of Indian map and draw the, mark the places in the map. So which are the places is given in your book, page number 153. Page number 153, which are the places is given? That Neyveli, it's located in Tamil Nadu. So Neyveli, then Arabian Sea, it is in a west side, Arabian Sea. The next one, Indian Ocean, it is in a south side, Indian Ocean. Then Bay of Bengal, it is in a east side. Then Salem, the iron mining in Kanchamalai, Salem also is given, Salem. Below that Neyveli, we can mark the Salem. Then one more thing, the forest region of Tamil Nadu. In case if they are marked the state, you just mark the outline of the Tamil Nadu. That's a forest region. The outline of Tamil Nadu. Outline, okay. That's a forest region of Tamil Nadu. So six places it's given in your book. The three oceans, Arabian Sea, Bay of Bengal and Indian Oceans. Okay. Then three more places, Neyveli and Salem. Then forest regions means it's a outline of Tamil Nadu, forest region. Okay. Get the new map, then mark the places in the map, stick in your fair note. Okay, students, in this session, it's over.